Now, WALB News 10 Sports with Shane Wright.
They're called the five senses: sight, smell, touch, taste, and hearing. Most of us have them. For Albany Panther defensive lineman Munir Muwwakkil, his five senses were reduced to four, but his inability to hear hasn't altered his ability to succeed.
To many of us, the game of football sounds like this. But for Munir Muwwakkil, football is without sound.
Everything was going good with Munir. He was a healthy, strong child, you know, never had any illnesses.
But all that changed one day when Munir was just 7 months old, when this bouncing baby boy was accidentally given another child's bottle at his daycare. What was a simple mistake turned into tragedy.
Munir contracted spinal meningitis, pneumococca pneumonia, and he became very ill. He became so ill to the point where he was on his deathbed when he was in the hospital.
I really was a mess. My initial response, I was a mess.
In a span of just a few weeks, the infection attacked Munir's brain and treatment proved ineffective. His prognosis was bleak. Munir was going to die. That's when one doctor brought up an experimental drug. It was the only way to save his life.
If Munir was to survive and he was going to make it through the night, and he would make it, there would be a 50-50% chance that he would live.
This time the treatment worked, but the side effects included either paralysis, blindness, or deafness.
His hearing was leaving him slowly and slowly and slowly to the point where it left completely totally.
Munir eventually regained his strength and began his life of deafness. He began playing football in high school, and after being shunned by his basketball coach, excelled as one of Florida's top high school prospects as a nose guard, and now has found his home with the Albany Panthers.
He said, if I practice hard and I improve, and everybody knows, he said, and I love it.
Each time I'm amazed, each time I'm very nervous. Where he landed as far as arena football, I'm happy if he's happy.
They told us that Munir would never go past the third grade. He would never go past the third grade. He would never get a high school diploma. And he would never go to college, never. This is what we were told.
So the young boy who was told he couldn't now boasts a list of accomplishments that's seemingly endless, proving the absence of sound is not the absence of ambition.
I'm deaf, but I improve. I go to college, I work hard, I have a job. You know, I look to the future.
And Munir will graduate college with a degree in interdisciplinary health from Western Kentucky this spring.